In this video, I'm going to show you how I take pictures for my clients that get tons of matches on dating apps. Okay. And what's inside this training? Really, what's inside this training is the foundations of this training come from the exact strategies that I used to go on 20 dates in 30 days in 2021. Should have made a YouTube video about that, but I didn't. So I think I'll probably have to do that again at some point. Maybe 2024. Maybe I do that then. And it's the same strategies I've used to get my clients 2 to 3 dates per week. And to prove that, I have some screenshots here. So Justin Thompson set up 2 dates in the same week. We also have Daniel, 4 dates in 4 days and 4 more planned in the next several days. Eric got his first date in 9 months. Deep had 2 dates in the same day. Still working on the actual date part. They just kind of walked around, but it was a good time, man. He hadn't been on a lot of dates in his life before. And in 1 month, Jonathan right here had been with 4 different girls. And I also have proof that this stuff works for me as well. I don't know where the fuck my camera went, but wait, let's go back. Okay. And I also have proof that this stuff worked for me as well. I also have proof that this stuff worked for me as well. Okay. So I have this girl I met on a dating app. I have this girl I met on a dating app that was bending over in front of me. I have this girl I did not meet on a dating app. This girl I met on a dating app. Same girl. This girl on a date from a dating app. I have this girl dinking cheersing waters from a dating app at my place. Holding hands with this girl from a dating app. Very cool. This girl in my bedroom from a dating app. This girl that I'm talking to on the street. I met up with her from a dating app. Yeah. So you get the point. This girl in my place from a dating app. Cool. So you get the point. All right. Lots of experience with getting dates from dating apps, and I'm not documenting every single girl that I hang out with. Right? Like I'm not doing that. The sauce that you're going to be getting inside of this training. So stick around because you need the matches first. All right. The messaging and stuff that comes later. But if you're not getting 5 to 20 matches a week, then like, what are you doing? There is literally no point using dating apps if you're not at least getting 5 matches a week. You should really be getting more. So I'm going to talk about how to take a good high quality photo, what equipment you need, how to find photographers for free if you need to, how to hire a pro, what things to look for in a pro photographer, the special pictures that you want to have in your dating app, like social proof pictures and pictures with girls or pets or whatever, and how to make them actually good to make your profile pop, how to edit your photos, and how to test your photos so you know you're using the best ones. Okay, so literally everything you need to know to get consistent matches, all right? So first, how do you take a good photo? Well, first, you need to follow this checklist, all right? Very easy. One, from the waist up, this is usually for your first photo. Definitely have at least most of your photos be waist up or close up enough where they can see your face. All right. You don't have to follow all of these on the checklist, but if you're not checking off at least 3 to 4 of them, then you're kind of fucked. Okay. It's not going to be good. Show your eyes. You can sometimes break this rule with sunglasses, but it has to be a really fucking good picture. And the sunglasses have to make sense. Context for photos makes a big difference. It matters a lot. Okay. Number 3, a stoic face or a candid smile. Okay. It's a lot easier for me to look away from the camera and go than it is for me to go, right? Like it's way easier. So if I'm actually smiling and I'm candid like this, like I feel like this is a pretty good candid smile. I'm like, I'm actually having a good time. I'm engaged with the camera. I'm having fun. It's not fake, but a lot of you guys are really fucking stiff and you're not relaxed at all. And it's impossible for you to have good body language. Okay. And so don't worry about smiling unless someone makes you laugh or makes you smile. All right. You need to have confident eyes, a confident smile. If you're going to smile, you might as well just do a stoic face. All right. Look away from the camera, basically in all of the photos, except for maybe one, if you want to be looking at the camera with like a candid smile, like a cheeky grin type of thing, but it should not be in most of your photos. You should be looking away from the camera. You should be focused on the world around you and not the camera. It gives off a very high status effect when you're focused on not the person looking at you, but you're focused on everything else going on around you. Okay. And then this is critical. Stop taking your pictures at noon when it's super sunny out. They look like shit. Okay. Take them at golden hour. Even if you only get one photo a day, take them at golden hour from, depending on, you know, right at sunset, within an hour of sunset, you need to be taking your photos, or on a cloudy day. All right. That is it. Those are the only times you take photos outdoors. And ideally, you take photos indoors that have good natural lighting coming in through the windows or whatever, but it's not harsh. Okay. Harsh lighting kills a photo. All right. It's going to completely kill it. You'll get like the, I'll see if I can do this with my, you get like the raccoon eyes like this. Like, look how shit that looks. I got this light here. That looks so bad. like what? You can't even see my head. My forehead looks like a fucking, like the opposite of a black hole. It's like a white hole. Like, you don't want that. Okay. Really fucking bad. You don't want that. All right. So how do you take a good photo? Well, a lot of these photos, as you can see, are almost waist up. All right. These are some examples of some clients that I've taken photos of. This is my client, Nate. He's looking away from the camera. He has good body language, good confident body language. It's from the waist up. It's close up enough to see his face. His face is a little covered up, but he's looking into the light, so I don't think that's a total killer. And I took one without sunglasses, and this one just tested better, okay, when we tested it. All right. Same thing here. No sunglasses. Devin had sunglasses here, but he took them off for the photo, okay? And we took this photo, all right? These are very critical, all right? Looking away from the camera. One thing I didn't really mention that's like a good bonus is like, dude, don't take them in like a shitty background, okay? Go to like a hotel, go to a nice part of town that has some good landscaping and actually has like a high status, makes you look like you're not fucking broke, like living out of a trailer. And if you are, get out of a trailer, right? Like, go to a nice place. Go to nice places to get your photos done, all right? Here's some more examples. Here's Nate again. Here's Nate. That's what I mean. This is what I mean by a candid smile. It's a really solid smile. Using props in the photo can be good. This is a little more in depth than I need you guys to worry about, but really just focus on looking like you're doing something and you're not looking at the camera. My client John here, looking away from the camera. Same thing, John looking away from the camera. All right. So, equipment. What do you need? You need an iPhone that shoots in RAW format, like a pro iPhone, or you need an Android that shoots in RAW format. Okay. If you don't know if your phone shoots in RAW format, look up your phone and say RAW format. It's going to be very obvious, but you need RAW photos to be able to shoot photos that'll be very easy to edit in Lightroom, which I'm going to show you later. All right. Or you get a DSLR camera. I have a Canon 80D. This is my dad's old camera. And I have, I think, a stock lens on it. I'm pretty sure this is a stock lens. It's an 18 to 55 millimeter lens. That's really all you need. Okay, you don't need anything crazy if you're going to take the photos yourself, which I would highly suggest. If you're interested in photography, you should probably get into it. Okay, here is quickly how to do it. I just pulled this from the Apple website. If you have an iPhone Pro, then which I actually don't, I always go with someone that has one. Then you want to just go into settings, camera, formats, then turn on Apple Pro RAW here. That's how you do it. You can look it up for whatever phone you have. It's very easy. All right. I believe in you. Now, how do you find photographers for free? Well, this is what I did. I would just go to Nashville Photography or wherever your city is, your area, whatever. If I was back in Springfield, Missouri, Springfield Photography or Ozarks Photography. If, you know, if I'm in a small town in like the Ozarks in Missouri or in Arkansas, I would be like Ozarks Photography. Okay. Cause it's more of a wide area. I might have to drive a little bit, but it'd be worth it. And then I just made a post. I'm looking to get shots done for my social media, but I'm new to modeling. Any new photographers looking to add photos to their portfolio? You make that post in 5 different groups. I promise you, you're going to find someone that isn't a fucking retard. Okay. I promise you. right? But here's why you should hire a pro. There are a million reasons why, but here are a few, okay? They'll be much better at posing you than you will be. They're going to be much better than a free photographer as well. They're going to be much better at recreating photos from examples that I'm going to give you later and that you could pull from my social media. And I'm also going to give you another guy that I think is genuinely like way better. I don't do professional photo shoots. I have no reason to like tell you that I'm the best. I'm just showing you what I've done to get results for my clients, which is like consistent dates and results I've got for myself, which is consistent dates. Okay. A professional photographer will also be focused on getting you the photos done quickly. Okay. They're going to want you to get as many photos as possible because they get paid by the hour. So they're going to want to, and they also understand the lighting. And if you're a pro photographer, you care a lot about your work. You care a lot about your portfolio. You're an artist. It's your craft. You want it to be good. You don't want to just go through the motions, at least if you're a good one. So this is why I would hire a good professional over basically doing anything else, or find some sort of value exchange for how you can, you know, if you have a big social media or something, then, you know, you can leverage that. Or if you have an ad agency or you have your own business where you can promote their business and help them, whatever you have to do to like exchange value for photos, that's what I would do. They'll also likely be able to edit your photos properly, so you don't have to do it yourself. They can also use presets. They'll probably have presets that you can use. I don't have any presets for this because I've gotten them from other photographers and I don't want to steal their shit. But like, there are plenty of people like Jay Harder Photo on Instagram. He has presets for sale. I don't know how much they are, probably $27 to $47. It's definitely worth it. And at the end of the day, pros get paid for a reason. So just show up prepared with proper style and you'll be good. So next, I want to throw it over to my friend Eric, who's actually a men's style coach that's going to coach you on how to dress in your photos so that you are the most attractive version of yourself, because you need to wear stuff that fits. You need to have good style. None of my clients here are dressed like shit, and that's why the photos look good. It's because they're dressed well, okay? And that's very important here. All right. It's very, very important that you dress properly. So I'm going to throw it to Eric, and I would definitely suggest following him so you can get some more advice on how to dress better, how to just show up better as a man.
Gentlemen, how's it going? My name is Eric, also known as Men's Style Hacks. And basically what I do is help out guys just like you master their sense of style, whether it's for dating, whether it's for confidence, for business, or just living a better life in general. Because life, my friends, is a game of look good, play good. And want to look better? Want to play better? Come to the right place. So let's talk about dressing in your dating profiles, the do's and the don'ts. First off, let me just drop the number one style hack, and that is the power of a watch. Because a watch makes literally any outfit look better. You can wear it with anything, t-shirt, jeans, wear it with whatever. It's always going to make your outfit look better. And why this works is because a watch, it shows status. Think of any CEO of a company or any rich entrepreneur, they all have watches. Now, you may think, oh, well, a watch costs a lot to look good, right? Nope. And that's the beautiful thing with style. You don't have to spend an arm and a leg to get something that looks good. Now, take these two watches, for example. I personally own both of them, and I get compliments all the time. I get questions all the time. Hey, is that a Rolex? How much do you spend on that? And when I tell them it was $75 off of Amazon, their jaws drop. Because people, they have this wrong mindset of, if it looks good, it has to be expensive. And that is just the furthest thing from the truth. So if you want to start with a watch, I recommend either Citizen Dress Watch or just any dive watch. You don't have to spend an arm and a leg. I got these for $75 as long as it looks good. Moving forward, let's talk about some of the biggest mistakes to avoid, because sometimes the easiest thing to do is just stop doing the wrong thing. There's no magic pill to take or magic path to follow. It's simply just stop doing the wrong thing. So let's talk about shirt colors. The bright red, the bright neons, the bright greens. I don't recommend bright colored shirts because a lot of kids wear bright colored shirts. You get cartoon characters, video game characters, all those bright colors for attention, for little kids' attention, and it makes its way into the kids' clothing. Now, if you're a mature, grown man who's got his life together, I just recommend keeping it boring, keeping it simple. Solid colored shirt, who cares about the logo, and a muted color. Muted color meaning looks a little flushed out. You know, it's not bright, it's not super eye attention grabbing. But it's going to look higher quality, and it's going to look more mature, and it's just going to look better at the end of the day. Next up are going to be the scorn of the earth, the tall white Nike socks. I see 80% of guys wear these, and they wear them wrong every single time. For some reason, I don't know who made it popular to think that, okay, I'm gonna wear tall white Nike socks with literally everything I own. Polo shirt, throw on these socks too. Wearing a suit, gonna wear these socks with it. I'm wearing jeans, I'm gonna wear sweatpants, gonna tuck them into these socks. I don't understand it. It just doesn't look good. It throws off the balance of the entire outfit. It just adds unnecessary bright white fabric to every single outfit. My recommendation are gonna be the no-show socks, because guess what? It doesn't matter what color they are, they're always gonna match your outfit. You know why? Because no one sees them. So when in doubt, just throw on a pair of no-shows and forget about the rest. If you own these, burn them, never wear them again. Some more mistakes to avoid are the baggy, saggy ass blue jeans. Now, there's nothing wrong with jeans, but there is a way to make jeans look good. And that's why I recommend either black or gray jeans that fit you well. Meaning not too baggy, not too long, not too short, not too skinny, but they fit your body shape well. And you don't have to be a stellar athlete or a bodybuilder, have enormous quads or great strong legs. It doesn't matter. As long as they fit your body shape well, like I said, not too tight, not too baggy. That's all that matters, and they're gonna look good. Next up is dressing with a loud, noisy outfit for attention. You know, something like this would be awesome if you're 16 and in high school. Oh my gosh, wow, you got the Gucci on, you got the designer on, wow, that's so awesome. But, you know, once you mature and you actually want to dress well and have a good sense of style, it becomes less about the name, but more about the color scheme, how it matches your skin, your hair, your figure. So, don't overcompensate, don't buy for the name, just keep it simple, keep it classy. So let's talk about shorts. If you have cargo shorts on and you're doing carpentry, you're working in a garage, you need that extra inventory space, fine. No big deal. But if you're wearing these out and about, you're trying to impress somebody, you're trying to dress up nicely for a specific occasion, just ditch the cargo shorts. They're just not a good look anymore. Go with something sleek like these 7-inch inseam shorts. I only own 7-inch inseam, and when I say 7-inch, I mean that's the length of the legs. They'll come right above your kneecaps, show off a little bit of your quad, which is great, gives you a little bit of a better tan line too. And they're just sleek, they match so many outfits, they go so well with so many outfits, and you can't go wrong with these 7-inch inseam shorts. Now back to the topic of buying for the brand, I don't recommend this just because if you're trying out new styles, you know, you could buy a $500 Gucci shirt, all white Gucci shirt, and find out that you don't like it. Well, shoot, now you're down $500 versus buy the $10 Amazon shirt, find out you don't like it, okay, whatever. Down 10 bucks versus you're down $500. Now, if you have the money to waste, okay, fine, go for it. But especially if you're starting out and you're trying out all these different looks, different styles, different color schemes, I just recommend keeping it simple. And you really don't need to buy the most expensive brands to have a good looking outfit either. So figure out the basics on something like Amazon, H&M, and then work your way up in cost to maybe Zara, Express, J.Crew. But you don't have to come out swinging and just buying the most expensive, outrageous designer. No, just buy something that's basic, that looks good on you, fits you well, solid color, that simple. Now, on that note of simplicity, here's my hot take, is that boring is better. I see so many guys with these awful, horrendous Hawaiian shirts. You don't need to wear something noisy and attention-grabbing, eye-catching like this. No, you just need to keep it stupid simple. Wear the solid color version of that shirt. Forget the design, forget the name, forget the logo. Just a simple, solid color, no name brand, no logo. Doesn't matter. It's always going to look better because it looks sleek. But just stay away from the wacky design t-shirts. Next up, oh, it's gonna be the Grim Reaper of every single outfit. I'll see guys wear a nice button-up shirt, belt, nice khaki pants, and then they ruin it with a pair of dirty ass athletic shoes. Now there's a time and place for these, you know, you're running, you're walking a long distance, you're hiking maybe, you're doing dirty yard work, fine, wear the athletic shoes, doesn't matter. But if you're specifically dressing up to impress, to have a photo shoot, or just you want to look good in general, I don't recommend wearing these. I recommend going with the basic, the boring, solid all white leather shoe, or the light brown leather penny loafers. And to show you guys how stupid simple style really is, let's say you're going somewhere high end, maybe a steakhouse, maybe a sales meeting, business meeting. You don't need to wear Gucci, crazy brand names. Just look, solid colored shirt with a collar, a watch, he's got a belt on, he's got solid colored pants, and then solid colored leather shoes. That's it. It's that simple. You don't need to overcomplicate it. Now, you want to dress down a little bit, a little more casual. So, short sleeve, collared, polo shirt, got the matching belt with the matching shoes, got some nice tan pants, and the watch on top. that simple. You don't need to overcomplicate it. And even if you just want to hanging out with your friends, maybe you're going to the bar, just keep it really low key. Look, black t-shirt, gray jeans, all white shoes, and a watch. One, two, three, four pieces. That's four pieces, and it looks great. It looks so much better than that dumbass Hawaiian shirt, that stupid Cowboys jersey, those zany, crazy colored Nike shoes. It looks so much better because you look mature. You look like you know what you're doing when you wear stuff like this. Best part about dressing like this is that it doesn't have to be stupidly expensive to look good. Just because something's $500 versus $10 doesn't mean it's gonna give you magic powers. Doesn't mean you're gonna get instantly 100 more dates or 100,000 more dollars in your bank account. No, it doesn't matter how much it costs. As long as it looks good on you, as long as it matches your eyes, your hair, your skin, your body shape, then it's a good look. Who cares about the price tag? It's not a game of price, it's a game of looks. But with all that being said, if you enjoyed this video, if you learned anything from it, go ahead, hit me with a follow on Instagram. If you want to work one-on-one, shoot me a DM. I'd be happy to help you out. But I hope you enjoy the rest of this training, and I'll see you in the next one.
All right, so big thanks to Eric for helping me out with that section of the video. He's way better at it than me. He understands fashion a lot more, men's style. And so that's how I would do it. So I'm really grateful for him being able to help. I would definitely give him a follow. Next up, we have these special types of photos. These are photos that guys really want to take, okay? And you know, you look up articles on like, what photo should I have? You know, what photo should I have in my dating app profile? And they'll be like shirtless photos, photo with the dog, photo with friends, okay? But you can't do this like shit, okay? Even if you have abs, you shouldn't do it, all right? If it's gonna be bad. Shirtless one is obvious. If it's gonna be bad, if you're fat and out of shape, don't take your shirt off, because girls will still want to fuck you if you're fat and out of shape, if you're cool and fun to be around, but they're not going to be more likely to fuck you if they see you're fat and out of shape and that's what you're advertising about yourself, okay? But also don't do a dirty mirror selfie, okay? This is an example. These two are examples of great photos that are shirtless. Photos are very clean. They're professionally done. The context makes sense. They're not just at home with their shirt off. They're doing something. He's out walking around with swim trunks on. He's at the pool, right? I got this one on the right from Jay Harder Photo. This one's Corey Chaw, okay? Corey Chaw on Instagram is also really good for high status photography. Okay, pet pictures. The key to pet pictures is compliance. If you don't have compliance from the pet, from the animal, then it's gonna look like shit. This picture right here that I just ripped from an article, it looks like the dog doesn't wanna be there. It doesn't look excited. Okay. You don't need to be overly excited, but the dog needs to be excited because that gives good vibes to the girl. It's a good sign if you look like pets want to be around you and pets want to cuddle with you. So this is another one of Corey Chaw. The cat's like sniffing him and shit. It's like really a good sign for a girl. It's going to be a very green flag. Okay. This one also good. This is actually from like a, I think it's like from like a pet food commercial or something. But like, if you can get a dog licking your face and you're laughing and you look good and you're dressed well, like that is going to crush on a dating app. Okay. Hobby pictures. This is good. This is from Jay Harder Photo. This is great. This is bullshit. This is very bad. Don't make the mistake of just because you're in a cool location of posting a shit picture on your dating profile. That's going to fuck you over. All right. Keep the pictures good. If the picture is not high quality and professional, there is no point in having it. Okay, there's literally no point. Picture with girls or a friend. Okay, these are fucking bad. This is an example of Corey Chaw. This would be bad on a Tinder profile. Okay, this might be good for Instagram. This might be good for social proof to like show to your friends. It would not be good at all for a dating app. It's too much competition. Okay, same thing here. First of all, the girl is not that hot. But second of all, it does not show that this guy's cool. He looks kind of timid. He's like smiling without teeth. He doesn't have a confident smile. His eyes are wide. This is a bad picture. I would not use this. I would do something like this. And my client, John here, is actually smiling and laughing at nothing. He's just acting like he's talking to somebody. And he thinks it's funny that he's trying to do that. And so he's having a good time. It looks like he's being social. It looks like he's being taken, you know, someone's taking a picture of him at like a party or at a get together with people. if you're going to have someone that you're talking to in the photo, it can be a girl, but it should be like just her hair in it or the back of her head. It should be something like that. It should not be super crazy fucking, I'm posing with this super hot girl at this party. Should not be like that with like lingerie and shit. Really bad. Editing photos is a very important process. If you don't edit your photos, then you're going to end up with photos like this before. And this photo on the right is way better in terms of it pulls out more emotion. It pops more. It's better. Okay. I wouldn't actually even say that this is the best edit of this photo. I think looking back on this one now, because I was editing them quickly, you could probably edit them better. And so I'm going to walk through exactly how I edit my photos in Lightroom right now. Yo, what's up, gentlemen? So I'm going to show you how to edit a few photos here in Lightroom, and it should really be kind of eye-opening for you guys. So I will say I have presets from Corey Cha because I've gone through his course. But what I would suggest you do is I would go to Jay Harder Photo on Instagram, and you can buy a preset pack from him, and the editing process will be very, very similar. It's similar presets. So for dating apps, we just want something very basic, okay? And so usually I like to use the essential one for this. Now you can just do this, but like you'll notice like it just looks a little yellow, kind of grainy, a little too bright maybe. So I'm gonna drop the exposure and drop the temperature on it until my skin looks a normal tone. That's the best way I can tell. Cool. And so I think I would be happy with this. Maybe I would crop it. If it's for Instagram, it's you want to do 4x5. If it's for a dating app, you actually can probably keep it as original. So I'd probably crop it in a little bit because I like to have the chandelier in there. Cool. So I would use that for a dating app. It's a little far away for a dating app. I probably wouldn't use this one for a dating app, but I felt like the lighting was good to show you guys. So this is probably what I do. Okay. And then I have another one here that's outside. And same thing. I don't think this one's perfect for a dating app, but I think it's good enough to show you guys. I would drop the exposure a bit, but this one, I would actually increase the temperature until my skin looks a normal tone. Cool. And then, you know, you can always mess around with some of the colors. Like you can increase the saturation in the sky. That looks a little fake to me, but I might do it a bit. And then I'd go maybe drop some of the oranges and then let's see. And then I think probably what I'd do is maybe increase the temperature a bit more. Now that the oranges are out of there. Cool. Yeah, that looks pretty realistic. And then one thing you can obviously do is adjust it. And I want to have my whole body in it. I want to have the whole Batman building here in Nashville in that. Boom. Cool. Maybe cut that out a bit. Cool. Awesome. There is one more thing called the rule of thirds. You kind of want to have the subject be on one of the thirds and looking into the photo. That's obviously ideal. Let's do one more. So this one was actually not shot in raw format, I don't believe. Yeah, no, it's just original, but I will go to the original format though, so you guys can see it without editing. Cool. So now I'm going to go into presets, and I'll probably do essential here as well. I kind of like the moody one. These presets from Corey are very good. You'll notice, like, because I didn't shoot in RAW format, there's, like, some weird artifacts and stuff from the smoke. But this is good to show you. Make it a little warmer, maybe. Drop the temp a bit. I actually think that's fine. I look a little fat in this. I've lost some weight since then, and this is kind of fun, so let's do one more. Fuck it. Okay, so this one I actually was not that happy with the edit of. I think it's a little over edited, so let's go back and we will do these presets again. I think I'll do this, but I'm probably going to drop the exposure. Maybe not that much. I'm going to drop the temperature down quite a bit. Not that much. Not that much. Starting to slow down the computer a bit. Cool. So that looks pretty reasonable. I think I look a little orange though, and so I'm gonna drop the saturation from the orange. And now I think I might bump up. I might make it a little more tan. Cool, and then you can see my fucking hairline, man. That's crazy. That's crazy. But yeah. So this is what I would probably do for this photo. I would probably bring it in a bit. I don't think this would be a good photo for a dating app at all. I think it would actually be really bad. this photo looks really bad for a dating app, but I actually don't think it looks that bad for my Instagram. And it's more of a story post anyway. I wouldn't post this on my actual grid. So this is how I would edit this photo. So hopefully this helps you guys kind of get some more basics on how I like to edit my stuff. This is a very good example as well. Skin looks pretty, you know, normal, not too bad. I think I maybe would, if I was going to go back, I might bump this up just a tad. And now we got this, right? And I think that's pretty solid. So anyway, guys, let's get back into the rest of the training. Okay, so now we're going to move on to testing photos. So instead of being in this dumb slideshow, I'm going to take you guys over to photofeeler.com. Okay, photofeeler.com is great because you get to literally test your photos. All right, so I'm going to show you how to do this. I have 10 credits up here, and I'm going to show you how to test the photos out for free. Very, very simple. All right, so I've done a lot of tests, and I've done a lot of bad tests, and I've tried stuff, and I do what works. Okay, so the important thing here is to always go with what is the most attractive. Okay. Now, I had a guy edit photos that were like super not looking like me, okay? And this one did the best, obviously, because I have a full head of hair and I look fucking sick. But it's not real, okay? I don't really look like that. But I do look like this, and that's a 7.2, and that's pretty good. What I've found is that it should at least be a 7.5 or higher to be a really solid dating app photo, and you should try to get 6 of those. And yeah, that might be hard. If it sounds hard, that's because it kind of is. All right. And that's okay. It should be kind of hard because if it was easy, every guy would be getting girls, but they're not. Obviously, that's why you're watching this video. So here's what I did. All right. I came into Photo Feeler and I tested this photo. All right. I tested all my photos, right? I do a photo shoot. I test all my photos. All right. I test all these. And I'd have an editor like, I mean, my editor was like fucking around and like adding smiles. These are unedited pictures. They're bad. Obviously, they're performing way worse. And then I did that to figure out which ones to edit. Cause at the time I was paying someone to edit the photos. And so I was like, all right, you know what? Edit this one and edit, I think, yeah, this one. All right. So we did that. And that was pretty good, right? 7.9, pretty solid, pretty happy with that. Okay. I also got 7.3, pretty happy with that. Not too bad. I tried to do a shirtless picture. I was not in good enough shape, I don't think. Got a 6.9, not that great. All right. Not too good. Okay. I did this photo, tried these photos, not too good. This one got a 7. And that's unedited. I was like, okay, not too bad. So I'm gonna try something. So I had my guy edit them, and this is what I got: 8.4, really good. 9.1, really good. I went until I got the best ones, and then I used them. That's it. Okay. So here is how, and this is, by the way, how mirror selfies perform. I just wanted to show you guys. And I'm in like good shape in this photo too. This is how mirror selfies perform. Don't fucking use mirror selfies. Please, dear fucking God. Holy shit. Okay. So this is what I would do. All right, gentlemen. take your best photo, new test. I'm just going to throw up one that I've tested before. We'll throw up this one. Dating, boom, age 26, females. I actually drop it to like this range. Females, and then you can pick, I don't have any karma, that's fine. You can pick the one you want, okay, with credits, or you can do this. And you can only test with karma once per one photo at a time, okay? And now what you do is you vote on photos to get karma, okay? And this is if you want to do it for free, all right? Cool, yes, yes. Yeah, she's cute, sure. Yes, yes, somewhat. Actually, no, she's not. She's not attractive, unfortunately. Yes, yes, no. I'm not attracted to her. Yes, yes, yes. I'm attracted to her. Yes, yes. I don't know. She's very hot. She's hot. This girl's edgy. I like her. And this is kind of how I do it. Like, this is a little scummy probably, but I go through fast and I'm like, yes, yes, no. And I just vote on attractiveness. That's all the girl cares about anyway. We go until we have high karma, and then we just wait, and that's it. If you pay for the credits, you can obviously vote one at a time, or you can vote more than one at a time and get an idea. Just so you guys know, the photos I post to Instagram are not actually good for dating apps. Like, you can see this, but they're cool, and they actually do help my brand have like a more luxury feel, more premium feel. And girls actually do comment on my photos being cool. Like, I actually get feedback from women that my photos are good. But on dating apps, they suck. So let's just look at the data. That's all that matters, okay? So in conclusion, what have we talked about today? We've talked about what makes a good photo, what equipment you need, how to find a photographer for free, how to hire a professional. We also talked about how to dress. We had Eric help you with that. We also talked about special pictures that make your profile pop. We talked about how to edit your photos and how to test your photos so you know you're using the best ones. Now you have everything you need in order to get consistent results with dating apps, at least in terms of matches. If you're still having trouble applying this stuff and you want feedback from me directly, DM me the word attract on Instagram if you want to apply for my one-on-one mentorship. I only take a few clients every single month, so if you actually want my help, if you want help approaching girls and setting up dates through dating apps and getting consistent dates so you can have abundance, build a rotation, have a girlfriend, whatever you're actually looking for in your dating life so you can focus on other areas of your life and stop being lonely, then I will help you do that. All you have to do is DM me attract on Instagram, but you need to do it quick because I only take a few one-on-one clients every single month.